Welcome to Professor Sartorial, where we discuss men's style, sustainable fashion, and capsule wardrobing. The topic of today's video is boots. But before I get into boots, I want to talk a little bit about my philosophy and my reason for beginning this project. My goal, quite simply, is to put an end to the fast fashion industry. Fast fashion is destroying the planet, and there's something that we need to do about it. So follow me, Professor Sartorial, and let's get to work bringing an end to the fast fashion industry. Now, before I get in a little deeper into this video, I want to talk a little bit about my 5 rules for shopping for new things. If you refer to my Sartorial Manifesto on ProfessorSartorial.com, I'll put a link to that down in the description, you'll see that I have 5 rules for whenever I buy something new to put into my capsule wardrobe. First rule is, no fast fashion. The fast fashion industry has created an overabundance of clothing, so much clothing that we can't even use it all. It's a major contributor to climate change and environmental depredation. Fast fashion industry, in short, is destroying the world, destroying the planet. So first rule I have is to avoid it at all costs. Part of the reason fast fashion is so successful is because it often has us chasing trends. So my second rule is, stop chasing trends. The things you buy should be timeless and classic, and most importantly, perhaps, durable. They should last a long time. Fast fashion relies on you wearing things for a season or less and then tossing it aside because the trends have changed. But I think you'll find that there are lots of images and styles that are timeless, and that there are lots of clothes out there that are durable, that will last for many, many, many seasons. My third rule has to do with capsule wardrobing. I think capsule wardrobing is a good solution to the fast fashion problem. I go into that in my Sartorial Manifesto, but I will say I have a rule for shopping when it comes to my capsule wardrobe, and that rule quite simply is, anything I buy has to replace something already in my capsule wardrobe, which I then will probably sell on Poshmark, or it has to become a foundational piece. Meaning if there's room in my capsule wardrobe, I currently have capped at 30 pieces. If there's room for a piece in that third limit of 30, then it can go into there. But I can't buy something just to buy it and have it. It has to have a purpose, it has to have a use, and it has to have a place in my capsule wardrobe. My fourth rule is, do your research. Find out where your clothes are made. Are they made with fair labor practices? I tend to prefer things made in the United States, but that's not always possible. Sometimes there's something that you might want or need that is made outside of the United States. So what you need to do then is do your research. Where is it made? How is it made? Is it made with sustainable materials? Are the workers paid fairly? What I have found is that a lot of clothing retailers don't have to disclose much of this information. So what I do is I contact them. I ask them, where are your clothes made? Who made them? Were they paid well? Were they working in safe conditions? Are the materials you use sustainable? Things like that. And I find they often answer me. And then finally, my fifth rule is quite simple. Have fun. Fashion is fun. There's nothing beats that feeling that you get when you buy something new and try it on and put it into your regular rotation. It's fun. So let's have fun. Like I said, today's topic is boots. I think that's a really fun topic. The next segment you'll see, I sort of set up my problem. I need new boots. The boots that are currently in my capsule wardrobe are just no good. So here we go. But as you can see, the water's pretty deep. Goes to the top of my sneakers. This is a problem I have to deal with a lot. It rains a lot here, so I don't want to have to stop walking just because it's rained a lot overnight. I just don't have the right shoes. I have these sneakers, they're good for CrossFit or the gym. So I need new shoes to walk in, preferably some boots. So you can see, I hope you can, the whole bottom of my cuff is soaked, which is okay.
But here's my shoes. Totally soaked through. They are totally soaked through. Ignore my ugly feet. So you can see the water that's coming out of these socks. So there's just no protection whatsoever in my tennis shoes. And, you know, duh. I should know that. But the problem is I don't really have shoes that will prevent this sort of thing from happening. So that is my quest.
So continuing my boot discussion, Chelsea boots, I think they're kind of cool looking. And so what I did was I just started looking at Chelsea boots and probably just picked out whatever was on sale and super cheap, probably from Nordstrom Rack or somewhere like that, and something that might be a name I'd heard before. And so I found these Kenneth Cole Unlisted. I'd heard of Kenneth Cole, but Unlisted must be like his off-brand where he sends the cheap stuff. You can see these boots are not good. They're made out of plastic, so they're not leather. You can see the creases. They're not even like cool creases. They're just, you know, you can tell that these are crappy. My favorite thing, and I have to reach for my readers here, is when you read the inside. The upper is man-made / textile. They can't even tell me what kind of textile or what man-made what. The lining is man-made as well. Outsole, man-made / textile, made in China. Maybe there is not an English word for whatever material these boots are made out of. That could be it. Doesn't translate well from the original Chinese, perhaps. But these are not great boots. And this is the reason that I'm out walking in mornings in sneakers and trudging through rain puddles and getting my feet wet and my sneakers soaked. Because I wouldn't wear these boots hiking. They don't fit well. They're terrible material. This is what I'm looking to replace. These really sort of garbage. I mean, that's what these are. These are garbage. They're not going to have a long life. They've probably gotten close to the end of their life. You can see there's already wearing. So that is my quest. That's what I'm looking for. I will let you know what I find.
So it turns out, boots, they're a whole thing. Any quick search on Google will turn up lots and lots of different reviews for boots. But I'm starting my research on boots with a few things in mind. I want something durable, stylish, and versatile, and oh yes, waterproof, or at least water resistant. I've looked at boots a few times before, but never really wanted to pay a premium for them, which is probably how I ended up with the crappy boots that I'm trying to replace. In the past, I've looked at Thursday Boot Company, and I liked what I saw, especially their Captain boot, which is a cap toe, a style I really dug without really knowing much about it at all. I have a soft spot for Doc Martens because I wore some of their shoes when I was a student in London in the 90s. And I come across an English company called Solivair that used to make the Made in England Doc Martens and now has their own brand, which are just like Doc Martens, but because of a lawsuit, they can't use Doc Martens' signature yellow stitching. But I kind of put aside my boot research for a while. That is, until I discovered the denim head subculture this past summer. After spending a month or so obsessed with Japanese denim, I discovered some YouTube sites that reviewed various salvaged denim brands. And it turns out that the Venn diagram between denim dudes and boot guys is a perfect circle. So that was when I discovered Boot YouTube, and wow, is it a thing? So many sites reviewing so many different styles of makers of boots, it's pretty overwhelming, but also kind of fun. I begin my search knowing that I probably don't want Chelsea boots this time. I'm not sure how much I love my cheap ones, and maybe I was just turned off the style for now. Also, they didn't really fit my criteria anyway, because they aren't really boots made for walking. So with my choices narrowed slightly, I began to watch a lot of boot YouTube, and a few styles stood out to me. One was Captoes, which had first caught my eye in my initial searches on Thursday Boot Company's website. The other was Mock Toes, which were the kind of boots Indiana Jones wears, which is pretty cool. It's classic Americana, and also because I'm a professor, you see. The Mock Toes Indiana Jones wears are made by Alden, a company based in Massachusetts since the 1880s. They're really cool boots, but they also cost about $600. Maybe someday when I become a YouTube star, I will be able to buy them. I took notice of a few other companies that the boot YouTube guys seemed to like. One was Grant Stone, which makes really high-quality boots in China, but not in a sweatshop. They're made by craftsmen. I really like their Mock Toes, which are called the Brass Boot. They are sleek-looking, and I like the brass eyelets with hooks. Another is Viberg, made in British Columbia, Canada. Their Cap-Toe Halkett book looks really nice, but yeesh, it's $825. Then there's White's Boots, based out of Washington State. Their M.P. Sherman Cap-Toes look really nice, but they're also more than $600. I've already mentioned Thursday Boots Company's Captain Cap-Toe Boots. They also make a Mock Toe called the Diplomat, which a lot of people like as well. I could go on and on. There's no shortage of choices out there for well-made, durable boots. But here's the thing, they're not cheap. Good boots can run from $200 to $800. One brand kept coming up as well-respected for its quality, style, and durability. That brand is Red Wing. Made in Minnesota, USA, these boots are a mainstay for boot dudes everywhere. One of Red Wing's signature heritage boots is its Cap-Toe Iron Ranger, and the other is their Mock Toe, which comes in a few different varieties. I like the look of both of them quite a bit. A lot of boot dudes go with Red Wing as their first pair of big boy boots, so who am I to argue with those boot dudes? I have decided that I will either get the Cap-Toe Iron Rangers or the Mock Toes, and it just so happens that there's a store here in town that carries Red Wing heritage boots, so I will go and check them out.
Okay, I am super pumped up, super excited. I have made a decision. As you know, I had narrowed it down to Red Wings between the Cap-Toe or the Iron Rangers and the Mock Toe. There is a store here in town that carries a lot of heritage brands like Red Wing, Danner, Wolverine, White's Boots. So I went and checked them out, and they happen to have both the Cap-Toe's Iron Rangers and the Mock Toe from Red Wing in stock. I tried on a couple of different sizes, I walked around the store, and I made a decision, and I purchased them. So, here's the big reveal. I feel like there should be a drum roll, maybe? Ah, yes. Very good. And maybe a little fanfare. Yes, so, here it is. I decided to go with the Mock Toe. These are Red Wings 1907s in copper, I believe, is the color. And as you can see, just a beautiful boot with the stitching. This is my first real pair of boots. So I'm very excited, very proud to have finally pulled the trigger and purchased a pair of quality boots. Here's the other one. A couple of things about this boot. Of course, there's the Mock Toe with the Mock Toe stitching. It's what they call storm welted, which apparently provides for some extra water protection, which I was very interested in. As you saw earlier, I often walk in water, gets wet, rains a lot around here. So I feel like these are boots that will hold up in the weather. I plan on beating these boots and testing them, beating them to hell as much as I can. I'm going to wear these boots every day. I'm going to wear them in the rain and the snow and the ice and everything in between. You can see it has a wedge heel. It's got pretty super treads. So I'm not worried about slipping on the weather. It has the cork midsole, which will eventually fit to my foot. So there they are. Look at these beauties. I'm very excited to start wearing these. So the final verdicts are these Red Wing mock toes, worthy of a space in my capsule wardrobe. And are they good enough to replace these boots, which are my current capsule wardrobe boots? And the answer is, yes, of course. These will most certainly be replacing these. These are going to go. Still, I don't want this boot to go into the landfill. There's still some life left in it. Somebody out there can get some use out of this. So I'm going to put it on my Poshmark site, in my Poshmark closet, and I will post a link in the description for these. $15, and they're yours. Maybe you know somebody who could use, and these are still stylish, and you can still wear them. There's still some tread left. So there's still some life left in these. I don't want them to go into the landfill. So go on Poshmark.
And now the exciting part, I get to go into my fall-winter capsule wardrobe inventory. Yes, I keep a Word document inventory of my capsule wardrobe, don't you? And now I get to replace the Kenneth Cole Unlisted with my new Red Wing mock toes. Very exciting.
Thank you for watching my video. Check out ProfessorSartorial.com for my Sartorial Manifesto. I'll also have other things on there, like how to get started capsule wardrobing, defining what capsule wardrobing is, all those things. If you're interested in following me on social media, I'm on Instagram at Professor Sartorial. I'll also post another video soon on the break-in process for these boots, which is proving to be quite the task, a little bit more difficult than I imagined it would be, so I'll share that soon enough. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you want more content from me, and remember, say no to fast fashion.